Riker to Counselor Troi. Your mother's just come aboard.
On the other hand...
Deanna, my dear, it's Mother!
Oh, I've got such deliciously exciting news. You're going to be absolutely thrilled. I'm getting married. You know, with just a bit of redecorating here and there, this 10-forward room should make a very nice wedding hall.
I beg your pardon?
Oh, where else, my little one? But here amongst all my good friends and in the presence of my adored daughter.
Mother, when did you meet this man? Who is he? I mean, marriage? When did all this happen?
My poor, plodding little Deanna with her questions, questions, questions. Wherever did you inherit such pedestrian genes? What matters, my little one, is that your mother's happy.
Mother, if you're happy, then I'm happy for you. I only asked who he is and where you met him. Those are not unusual questions.
He's such a wonderful man, and he has such good breeding. Oh, I tell you, he's absolute perfection.
Who is he?
He is Compio, third minister to the Conference of Judges from the planet Costellane. Royalty, my little one, naturally.
I didn't even know you'd ever been to Costellane. Or was he on some diplomatic mission to Beta Z?
Well, neither, actually. You see, we haven't exactly met yet, really. Oh, but the profiles we've exchanged, why, they are in such accord that you could weep, my little one, you would weep at the harmony between us.
Mother, don't you think it would be a good idea if you actually met the man you're going to marry before committing to spend the rest of your life with him?
Deanna, I love you, but you do make everything sound like an epitaph.
I don't want to agree.
But you have to agree. That is what an agreement is. Counselor Troi, excuse the intrusion, but we're having some difficulty drawing up our contract. Hmm? Mrs. Troi.
He's not fair.
The boy is unreasonable.
Well, of course he's unreasonable. He's a child. Aw, it's such a child. You know, making little boys reasonable only gives them pimples.
Alexander, this is my mother.
Alexander? What a wonderful name. You know, I once knew a tall, handsome warrior named Alexander. Oh, he utterly adored me. And we went everywhere, simply everywhere. Have you been anywhere yet? Contract? What contract?
Between father and son. A fair and balanced way to achieve a mutual sense of order.
Well, how ghastly for you. And you are doing this to your own child, Mr. Wolf?
Mother?
It is Worf, madam.
Contracts are usually between people who don't really trust one another. A child who is trusted becomes worthy of that trust.
Mother, would you kindly stay out of this?
And if he does not perform his contractual duties, I assume he will be chastised?
He will be sanctioned, yes.
Mm-hmm. And if you fail to perform your duties, what is the child supposed to do about it?
Mother, will you please?
I not perform my duty?
Alexander, now life's true gift is the capacity to enjoy enjoyment. Now, have I arrived too late? Or, can you still smile?
Married? She's getting married.
Yes, if we stay on our present course, we should rendezvous with her intended in 31 hours.
I will not have that woman continuing to use this ship for her convenience simply because her daughter happens to be one of my officers.
Apparently, Deanna being on board is only part of the reason.
The other reason being?
She thinks the honor of giving away the bride should fall on you.
Permission for an onboard wedding is granted, number one. Nothing will please me more than to give away Mrs. Troi.